You couldn't hear me then, could you? You couldn't hear me then. I didn't push my button. Just a moment. I'll do it again. Well, let's start that again. One moment, please. One moment, please. Good morning. It's Friday, the 31st of March, 2017, with the end of March. Is that the Ides of March? Is that today? Beware the Ides of March. Is that what it is? The Ides of March? Or is that a different... I can't remember what date that is now. The Ides of March, but never mind. We're there anyway. I'm sorry for that moment of silence. There were probably some people watching this exciting, hard-hitting, global television programme at that moment, thinking to themselves, oh, it's going to be a lovely, quiet show today. But fortunately, I have located the little yellow light on my equipment here, boys and girls, that indicates to me that the microphone was on mute. We were muted this morning. Muted. Muted. Yes, indeed. It's still quite nice weather outside, I must say. Last night, on the way to work, after I finished the battle on the way to work last night. Oh, Ross, I'm glad you're there. I've got some of your Facebook updates this morning. Facebook updates are coming up within the show today. There'll be an item of fake news. I won't tell you it's fake until the end of the show, OK? You try and work out which one is fake while we're going through the show. And, of course, interesting Facebook updates. If you use Facebook to update yourselves and it's amusing or interesting in some way and I happen to come across it, what I do now is take some of those off there. And there's a few this morning from Ross Patzo. He's quite humorous sometimes when he's not sitting his there stuffing his face with a bag of crisps. Or... rather disappointingly listening to the disgusting piece of filth known as Russell Brand. Apparently he's a Russell Brand fan. Oh, I mean, does he ever wash that nasty, long, greasy hair? What a disgusting piece of filth he is. And unfortunately, Ross Patzel is a fan of his. Oh, you love all the best people, don't you? What a good job you love me as well, Ross. You know, it kind of evens it out a bit to the crap and the fantastically good, really, doesn't it? It does. Like yin-yang. Is it yin-yang? Yin-yang. I don't know what the hell's all that about. Anyway, so last night I got in the car and I got in the car about 9 o'clock. I actually left early last night for some inexplicable reason because I don't like to get to work to certain jobs too early because there's nothing to do. You know, the trouble is you start going in early and they expect it all the time. Oh, well, you were here at 9 o'clock last week. Why is it 10 o'clock? Well, 10 o'clock's my time. But why were you here at 9? Perhaps you could like to start. No, I wouldn't like to start at 9 o'clock. 10 o'clock's my time. Thank you very much. We can't be just starting early. What, for free? For free? Oh, could you do it as a favour? Do you ever get that at work? Oh, could you do a favour? A favour, a favour, a favour. And then the week you don't want to do it, oh, that's really nice, isn't it? You don't do favours. And yet you've done 200 of them already, dear. They take the mick, don't they? They take the mick. They really do. Yes. Anyway, so I came out of my house and I thought, my God, it's warm outside. And it really was. And that warmth last night remained the whole night. In fact, it got incredibly hot in the pub last night. I have to say, really hot in the pub last night. And it was, I said, have you got the heating on? They're like, no. And then on the way home, I left the pub. I had my jacket. Well, I didn't have my jacket on. I had it over my arm. Walked back to the car in a T-shirt in March. Very, very strange and mysterious. Yes, it is. I reckon it's global. It's got to be global warming. There is no global warming because that's all fake news. Fake news. Donald Trump said so. So it must be true. Fake news. There is no global warming. I'm telling you that now. No global warming. Anyway, so on the way to work last night, it took me forever to get there. This is only 9 o'clock at night, so that's hardly overnight. I mean, what would you class as overnight? You know, overnight roadworks is like I don't know, midnight till 5 a.m, isn't it? Wouldn't you class that as overnight? So I'm heading off towards my motorway, and it's very hit and miss if that's closed. At the moment, they're making part of the M3 a smart motorway. And guess who's on that part of the motorway? Hello, yes, Bracknell, where I live in Royal Berkshire, is part of that bit that they're making smart. And they keep closing the damn road off. Now, this has been going on since 2000. This has been going on for 2 years. Not since, it's not that bad. Since for 2 years, okay? And they're not going to finish until December. We're sick of it. We're sick of it. So I'm getting to the motorway, and guess what? It's closed. Oh, well, it's closed. So now, normally, so I would come along my road and turn left to get onto the motorway. And there they are. The usual cones with the little flashing lights coming out, making three lanes into one so that you have to go along into that lane. And then you get to there, and as usual, there's like a van parked across the entrance to the motorway and two blokes drinking tea. Now, whenever I go past this particular van, or it's more of a truck, whenever I go past this truck, there are two or three blokes sitting in there drinking tea. I think that's all they do. I think their main purpose is to just sit there and laugh as you get there and realise, and then you swear, you know, some people under their breath. I just open the window and I scream at them. I just scream at them and they just laugh at me as I go past. So usually I'll then go round and then I go straight over. Guess what? They closed that road as well. How can you do the two roads at the same time? So now I've got to go down the motorway the wrong way to the next junction and come back round again. I couldn't believe it. I thought, well, we better get on with it. And the other thing is, you can't put your foot down to make up time. Oh, no. Average speed cameras. Flash. And what are average speed cameras? Are they to help traffic? No. I believe that these places where they have things like average speed cameras and speed cameras, I think it's a pervert. I think there is a pervert watching these cameras, zooming in to people that he fancies, probably got loads of me. You know, let's be honest, I'm not ugly, am I? I reckon there's a bloke who's in a little office somewhere and is zooming around with these speed camera things, and then he zooms in into your windscreen, if he fancies it, and takes a picture like that of you. He downloads it onto a little memory stick thing. What are they called? You know, those things, USB sticks. Takes it home, gets into bed, plugs it into a telly. God knows what he does with his hands then. They are perverts looking at us through these speed cameras. This is always amazes me, doesn't it? You know, as a father, uncle, mother, whatever, of a child that goes to school and they have a sports day. Oh no. No cameras, no photos. You're not allowed to take photos. You're not allowed to take photos. And yet, there are perverts all over the country, boys and girls, watching you through traffic cameras. Click. Oh, yeah. Oh, let's have a... Oh, I like... You can imagine the sort of people sitting there, can't you? Oh, let's have a little picture of him. Yeah. Oh. And that's what they're doing. So you can't put your foot down going the wrong way down the motorway because they've got the average speed cameras. Oh no. Oh no, they're not speed cameras. They are safety cameras. Yeah, right, of course they are, mate. We all believe you. We all believe you, Mr. Policeman with no sense of humour. Yes, I have a great time for the police, I'll have you know. Thank you. It's just Do you know the traffic police are hated by the ordinary police? Did you know that? That is true. That is a true thing. Yes. So I'm going down this road. I thought, okay, well, just get on with it. So I'm going down there and then I'm come to the next junction. And it's not a short hump. It's not a short jump between junction 3, where I am, and junction 4, where the next one. That's quite a long distance. It's not like a little one. So I'm going down there. Eventually, I get there now. And I turn around and I noticed on the other side, there are cars going the other way. First of all, don't say they've closed that side completely, but there were cars. So excited as I was, I thought, at last, here we come. So I left the motorway, going round the roundabout. Now, which one is it? M3 going to London. Oh, there it is. Coming to the... They've closed it! They've closed that one as well! You couldn't get back on to the M3 to go the other way. Now I'm lost. I'm lost now. So I'm kind of on this dual carriageway. Hardly loads of other cars. Lorries coming, and there was a little bit to stop, you know, a pull in to park. So I stopped there and fired up the sat-nav. Now, more recently, I don't know what's happened to my TomTom sat-nav. It's still quite good, but it doesn't seem to always know which roads are closed because I've got the traffic thing on it that I pay £1.25 a month for. And it hadn't told me that the motorway was closed. So, of course, this thing is now trying to get me back onto the motorway that I know is closed because I've just gone past the barriers. Oh, Lord. Eventually, I went to, I headed towards Camberley and the A30 London Road, hoping that that would be, you know, that would be okay. And I went on my trip. And as I'm driving on the A30, I suddenly realised going by A Road, I was going back to exactly the same place that I'd left Bracknell at. Ha ha! And after half an hour of driving, I was back in exactly the same place that I'd left at. Except, there you go, M3. There you go, A30. Oh, what a disaster that was. So I've got to ring up the work. You know, I'm sorry I'm going to be a bit late today because they keep closing all the roads. I mean, how can you close all the roads going in the same direction at the same time? I mean, they really are thick, these councils, aren't they? You know, for my £84 a month council tax charge, or whoever runs it, the Highways Agency, very, very important people. Nope, arseholes, all of them. They couldn't organise a piss up in a brewery, could they? They really, wouldn't you just do one at a time so that people can use another route? Stupid idiots. Thick idiots. Eventually I got to work. So there we are. But of course, you know, I'm on an A road now. You can't put your foot down. And even if you wanted to put your foot down, you can't because there's the lorries and the cars, all that have similar to you have got lost. Mad. It's just mad, isn't it? So I did my job last night. Lovely night. The two brewers. Really nice. I got a clap at the end. They liked my music. God, when's the last time that happened? It's only because I play requests. You have a DJ there. I don't think he plays many requests. I try and play all the requests, except for stupid people who ask for things that are like nothing is in key, you know, like really heavy R&B. Like the one I always used to make a comment on, "Drunk in Love" by Beyonce. Well, not any of that stupid stuff. I don't care if she looks nice and she's got a lovely bottom, boys. I'm not playing "Drunk in Love." It's awful, awful song. So we had a great night last night, and then on the way home, once again, A3 closed, M3 closed. M4 closed. So I've had to go back over the bridge on the A4, and what should take me 45 to 50 minutes to get home took me an hour and a half. Oh, I don't understand it. How can you do all the same roads going the same way at the same time? So that was my journey home last night. Most depressing and disappointing it really was. Let's do some of your messages coming in this morning. Good morning to you all, boys and girls. And we've got some wonderful Facebook update things for you to read out straight after I've done these first lot of messages for you. Good morning to Sean Michael Sean Michael Crabtree. Good morning, Sean. Wendy's with us this morning. Ray Reynolds is there. Rod Brown. Vectis says, Wendy is in a bit of an aggressive mood today. Talk to her nicely. No, Vectis. Wendy is not aggressive, darling. You are the aggressive one, mister. Wendy is not aggressive. Wendy is never aggressive. She is always nice and happy and smiley. She is smiley, Wendy is. Tim Partington's with us. Morning, Tim. Ross Patzelt says, I'm here on a bit of a break at work. Low battery. Oh, you've probably run out by the time I read your Facebook status. Is that then, Ross? You need to... Haven't you got one of those little portable charge things? What are they called? A power bank. Have you not got a little power bank? You can get those from Argos or somewhere like that. A power bank. That's what you need. Vectis says, do you need a hand with your knobs? Not from you, darling. Christ almighty. No, thank you, Vectis. Don't fancy anyone my own age, do I? Dear me. Can you just imagine that? Me chatting someone up my own age. How embarrassing would that be? No. DJs and radio presenters have to have young, good-looking partners, you know, with pert bodies. Excuse me. Good morning to Stephen, who's in Australia. Morning, Stephen. Anne Taplin's there. Good morning, Anne. Tim says, I do a feature on Karaoke 7 UK called You Say, We Say. Now, that's a little Facebook group, OK? Karaoke 7 UK, which highlights some of the interesting Facebook updates. Oh, you do it as well, do you? Also tweets and posts on other sites. There was one yesterday about Victoria Beckham. Oh, please, oh dear. What a miserable old cow that is. You just imagine having her as another half or a mother. What a... Like this. All that. All pout. Just pouting all the time. What a miserable cow that is. God's sake. Anyway, there was one yesterday about Victoria Beckham who's lined up with Carpool Karaoke with James Corden. Can I say his name on here? Of course, James Corden is fine. He's all right. And there was a comment from someone calling themselves Steam Johnny. And he said, Vic Beckham returning to her musical roots. She was to sing Burning Man. She was to singing as Bernard Manning was to synchronised swimming. Could any of them sing? Those Spice Girls. Oh, Zach Thompson is with us this morning, who says, Chris, I've not been about. I've been on holiday. Hope you're well. Where have you been, Zach? Have you had a nice little holiday somewhere? Have you been on a haven holiday in a caravan? I keep looking at caravans, you know. I'm sure I will buy a caravan at some point. Not a mobile one, a static one. Hopefully in Lincolnshire, now my sister. Although there is one place up there that I really, really like. Tattershaw Lakes. You can look it up if you want. Tattershaw. Tattershaw Lakes, but they're bloody expensive there. They're really expensive. There's another one a little bit further nearer to my sister called Willow Holt. So I might have a little look around. I'm thinking about next year, early next year. I've got a little time, a little plan in my head. Have you got plans? I hope you've got plans to come and see me tonight at my karaoke. Central Station karaoke tonight, boys and girls. It's Friday Night Out with Chris Reardon from 8:30 to midnight. I'll tell you about that more. At the end of the show. It's in King's Cross, Central Station, King's Cross karaoke tonight. Anne says, council spending all the money before the next financial year. Oh, is that what it is? That could well be what it is. Yes, you might well be right there, but they are doing an awful lot of roadworks all going in the same direction. Chris, could you give away power packs so people can watch your show in full without the risk of low battery? We could do that as a prize. Actually, I think I've got a spare power pack somewhere. Now, where is that? It might be downstairs. I hardly use them. It's one of those items that you never use and then you go on holiday and then you buy another one because you've thrown the other way, isn't it? All right. Facebook updates, boys and girls. Let's do some of these Facebook updates for you this morning. There we are. So I've been collecting these just before we went online this morning. Not on air. Online. On air is for small radio stations and TV stations. They're on air, dear, you know. Little transmitter on the top of a hill somewhere, broadcasting 30 or 40 miles. No, this is an international programme coming through proper wires, dear. Proper wires, love. Big, thick, black cables, just as I like them. This morning's Facebook status is, there's three here from Ross Pat Delt. internet radio star. Here's number one. I've never believed in orthopedic shoes, but I stand corrected. I tell you what, when my sister stands in one place too long, there's a terrible dent in people's carpets. Terrible dents, dear. Ross also says, my woodwork teacher said I never get anywhere in life if I keep firing staple guns at people's faces. If only you could see me now. If you could see me now. I like that one. I've been going out with a caterpillar. Though lately we've grown apart. It's her fault she's changed. Oh, those legs, dear. Oh, my God. All those legs on the caterpillar. I mean, what do they do with them all when they're doing it? You know. All those. Just imagine all those legs being wrapped around you at the same time. You wouldn't be able to escape again, would you? How awful. Thank you very much, Ross, for those wonderful status updates this morning. From you, there's some more. Stuart Brown. Good morning, Stuart Craig Brown, veterinary expert, looker after of little sick animals. Old cat was sick last night. Oh, I got in from work. Now, I'd already cleaned up one lot of poo. I got in, and as I opened the door, the smell hit me. Oh, but fortunately, she had gone on one of my newly installed puppy pads. Do you remember the puppy pads? I showed them to you a few shows ago. If you miss shows out, you miss these things, you see. I'm not getting them. No, I'm not getting them again. It's your fault for missing the show. A couple of shows ago, we gave away a holiday for two in Barbados. You weren't there then either, were you? Oh, well, could have been you, but it wasn't. Talking of things to give away, I have been asked if I'd be interested in resurrecting my bingo night in Hemel Hempstead. Yes, is that near you? We might be doing bingo, and it'll be done properly. None of these little machines, click, click, click. No, we need a ball machine. You know, you switch that thing on, push, and it bursts into life. Little balls dance around inside the glass box, and you pull one out. 8 and 9, 89, and another one comes up. 6 and 3, 63. Bingo. I used to love doing bingo. Oh, my God, that was great fun, that was. So, Stuart Craig Brown writes, bitched a woman on the train this morning for having her bag on the seat. Made her move it. Then sat on the seat and sat on chewing gum. Oh, the shame when I tried to get up and realised I was stuck to the seat. That's karma, that is, Stuart. You should mind your own bloody business, dear. Mind your own business. God has got you back for... But that poor lady... With a little bag. Oh, I bet it was a tiny bag as well. And you just had to make a point, didn't you? You should have kept your mouth shut, Stuart. Poor lady in her bag, dear. The lovely Diana Bell. Oh, Manolo girl. One of our Manolo girls says, I've learned that people will forget what you said. People will forget what you did. But people will never forget how you made them feel. And that's a quote from Maya Angelou. Isn't that a lovely thing? How am I making you feel today? Eh? When was the last time I was felt? I can remember when I was felt by various different people over the years. Oh, I was felt last Friday by Gustav. He had a little squeeze of my bum. You do know, and I keep mentioning this to your boys and girls, because I don't want you to miss out. I don't want you to miss out. When I'm at, we get a lot of articles now. In the newspapers, people who have been so-called sexually harassed. Oh, dear me, do me a favour. And I mean, some of these people, for God's sake, well, you see them in the paper. I've been sexually harassed or something like that. And then there's a picture of them and you look at them and you're thinking, who the hell would want to touch you, you ugly piece of dirt? Who would want to touch you? I don't think so. And what they do, they go to the Sun. It might be, you know, a girl who's been with a Premier Football League person. Because they're all after them, aren't they? I know this is a fact. Only a few months ago, and I haven't told you about this, I put a football kit on and stood near where the players come out at Chelsea. You know that little tunnel thing? I stood near there and people thought I was a Premier League footballer. They saw me in my little tight top and my little sparkling white shorts. Well, they weren't quite sparkling. I was so clean. Because they're clean when they put them on, aren't they, those footballers? They are clean when they put them on. It's only after a game, you know, when they're dirty and sweaty, aren't they? And they must have that smell of the footballers on them. Oh, I'm feeling quite weak at the knees now, dear. I really am. Well, I was there dressed as one of the footballers and they looked at me and they thought, my God, there's a Premier footballer. Girls and boys were throwing themselves at me, boys and girls. And I had to withdraw myself. I had to withdraw myself to a safe area. The little cafe round the corner. And I came in there and people were looking at, my God, look at those legs and arms. You must be a Premier League footballer. That's what they said to me. It's true. But these people, what they do is they get with one of them and then they sell the story to the newspaper, don't they? Dreadful people. But what I'm saying is that I'm not going to do that. If you touch me, I'll squeeze me as I'm walking through the millions of people that appear at my karaoke and quiz nights. I'm not going to take you to court. You squeeze and touch as much as you want. Now and again, I may jump because I'm a bit ticklish. I wish I hadn't told you that. I wish I hadn't told you I'm ticklish, but I am very, very ticklish. And sometimes it's Gustav who seems to have the most feeling than anyone else. Sometimes he touches me and I jump. And I don't want you to be offended if that doesn't mean I've changed my mind, OK? You touch and feel as much as you want as I walk round because I'm not going to take you to court. Because to me, it's all a little bit of a laugh. The world is a laugh. The world is... come in, look at Donald. Look at our Donald. He's a laugh, isn't he? He can't seriously be doing all those things that he keeps saying he's doing. No, he's having a joke with you all. Don't believe a word of it, lovers. Here's another one. This is a really nice one from... now, I want to get your name right. I'm not quite sure how to say your name. Let me just put on my bifocal glasses. Siams, is it? I hope it's Siams. Siams Llewellyn, good morning, sir, who says in his Facebook update this morning, a former classmate challenged me when I said another one was in good hands medically when he was scheduled for a biopsy. Yes, she said, but I'd add he's in God's hands too. To which I couldn't resist adding the following. So a lady said to me one time, I've survived 3 car accidents, pneumonia and peritonitis. You can't tell me that God doesn't have plans for me. I commented, sounds like he's trying to kill you. Excellent, Siams. Excellent, sir. And one more status update this morning from radio star Mike Cullen, who says, me mum, give me some Chinese noodle thing today. So I was in the kitchen making it. Boiling water on it. Let the noodles soak up the water. Anyway, I had this mad thought pop into my head, which made me burst out laughing. I've never seen a Chinese takeaway. Called Waka Noodle Do. Why that popped into my head, I don't know. Waka Noodle Do. Wonka-noodle-doo! There we are, they're this morning's Facebook updates for you, boys and girls. They're very, very good, aren't they? Very good indeed, I do like those. Keep putting them on there. Or if you ever see one that you think's quite interesting, send it over to me and I'll read it out in the next show, OK? Tim Partington says, have got a message from Leslie Ann Brewers on Twitter. She's on that quiz show, The Code, which is on BBC One Colour. Never heard of it. The Code, dear? What's that about? There's been no good quiz shows since they stopped Call My Bluff. Ba, 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 ba. Or do you remember Ask the Family? That was a nice theme tune. Da 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 da. That's 1970s, that one, with Robert Robinson. It was, and people used to answer the questions there straight away. Have you noticed people on quiz shows now? They leave a gap. You know, so the question might be, let's think of something. Ah. What is the main colour on this piece of paper? Is it red, blue, or green? Okay? So that would be the question. Years ago, someone would push a buzzer. Is it red? Yeah, that's right. And that's it. That's done. Done. Okay, all done. Nice and straightforward. Now, I don't know why it is they do this now. Okay? So once again, the question, what is the main colour on this piece of paper? Is it red, blue, or green? And then it goes over to the contestant. Ah. Now, I don't think it's green. I'm pretty sure it's not green. Because it doesn't look green. And green is the colour of trees' leaves. Although not all trees' leaves. Some of them have slightly red depending on the time of year. So I don't think it's green. It could be red, but I'm not convinced that it's red. I think I'm going to go with blue. And then the quiz host will go, right, are you sure you want to go with blue? And they're like, well, my aunt had a piece of paper that's blue and it looks the same to hers. You sure you want to go with blue? Yes, sure we're going to go blue. Okay. Blue has been locked in as your answer. And then there'd be a noise. Like that. Okay, let's find out the answer. What's the answer? Is it red, green, or blue? Then there's another gap. And it'll go, it's red. It's taken them 10 minutes to get that blasted answer out of them. Why? Why can't you just say it's blue or red or green? Oh, and it's like pulling teeth half the time. The only thing is I can think of is that there's been so many quiz shows over the years, they've run out of questions. So the very few questions that they've got left, they have to string out in a long line. What a load of crap television is. Dear me, it's all over for television. Thank you very much. I've never heard of The Code, which is on the BBC One Colour Report, apparently, according to Tim Partington. Apparently, I'm describing, are you smarter than a 10-year-old? Am I? I don't know what it is. Anne likes eggheads. Oh, do you remember that CJ? He was great. Oh, weren't he awful? I used to hate him. Now, I nearly went out with him years and years ago, about 25 years ago. I was working in this place in Earl's Court called Harpo's, doing DJing and karaoke there. And he used to come in. I nearly went out on a date with him. I'm glad I didn't. Oh, and he awful. He was just so horrible, that man. Tim says, top of the form. Oh, da-da-da, da-da-da. Was that top of the form? I think it was. Yes, I think it was. Tim says, I remember Call My Bluff and Ask the Family. Yes, indeed. Robert Robinson did both shows. And Call My Bluff went in for some years, didn't it? It did go on for some years. And the host and indeed the teams changed constantly. Tim says, Twitter update from Buddha wristbands. Walk away from anything that gives you bad vibes. There's no need to explain or make sense of all. It's your life. Do what makes you happy. I am. That's why I'm sitting here. Being happy for you boys and girls. Happy, happy, happy. That's what we need. Happiness. Ba-ba-da-ba-ba. Happiness. Happiness. The greatest gift that I possess. And thank you, a couple of people, sharing today's show on your walls. Thank you very much, Tim. Tim, sometimes I think, shall I put one of my shows on the karaoke walls? Can you just imagine that? They go mad. Oh, why have you put this on here? It's nothing to do with karaoke. Moan, 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 moan. Go away. Rod Brown says, I will give you a squeeze if you do bingo at Hemel. Love bingo. Love coloured balls. Is Hemel your fake news? It might be, Rod. It might be. Bingo in Hemel Hempstead. Not soon. Not soon. This is an item now being worked on by me and my very good friend. Thank you. Ray Reynolds says, thank you, Ray. Not going to read that one. They might attack me, darling. Tim Partinson says, you can't say two fat ladies in bingo anymore for some reason. Why not? I will. I will say two fat ladies and I will point them out in the pub. Adam says, it took me 3 hours to get out of the shop today. Well, walk faster, you lazy git. 2 hours. Were you doing pigeon steps? These, it's like these people with these step counters. Have you seen those? I've done 4,000 steps today. Oh, I'll just do another two. 4,002. Sad people. Walking around with those Fitbits on, counting their steps. I bet you do more steps for about 2 days. And then you go back to normal. And you keep, is it not working? Yeah, of course it's working. You're just not moving fast enough, you fat git. Dear me. Adam says, I bought some new shoes the other day. They're made out of tortoise skin. Took me three... Adam, you better put the same... If it's going to be one joke, I suggest you put it within one comment, dear. Because we've missed that now, haven't we? Dear me. Ah, Ross has got his charger connected now. Did I miss my bits? Yes, you did. Do try and keep up with us, Rod. Ross. Thank you. We might get Joel down tonight at the Central Station. Thank you very much. Let's have a look there. Buy a caravan and rent it out when not in use. No. I don't see the point. If you're going to buy a caravan, it's for you, isn't it? And maybe close friends and family. I don't see the point of buying a caravan and then renting it out. You might as well just rent one when you need one. I don't get that, people that do that. I understand it's to make some money, but you know, the last thing you want, you know, isn't it nice to go on? I mean, I couldn't bear anyone sleeping in my bed again. I'm sure I couldn't. I'm sure, not unless it was someone like Cristiano Ronaldo. Oh, did you see the article on him yesterday? That someone's made a bronze statue out of him. I don't look anything like him. It's awful. It's absolutely hideous. I don't think I'm going to have any brass statues made out of me. I think the best way to make things like brass statues is to get the molten liquid, okay? And then when the person is dead, presumably, you know, before they decompose too much, you put them in the brass, you dip them in it, pull it out again, and then it'd be perfect, wouldn't it? That brass statue of Cristiano Ronaldo is hideous. Oh, it's awful. Awful. Good. Okay. Shall we do some news? Oh, we haven't. Are we doing phone calls today? You don't want to call in today, do you? Eh? You don't want to call in today. I've got to tell you. Oh, now, do I tell you this or not? Shall I tell you this? Oh, I don't know if I should. Should I tell you or not? Should I tell you? I might do in a minute. Anne says, like a death mask. That's the one, Anne. Have you got one on, darling? You looked like it the other day. A death mask. A lot of them have got those on in Sainsbury's, I reckon. Miserable people up there. Oh, miserable. Don't go on Sainsbury's on a Sunday. They're horrible people. Staff and customers. You've never seen so many miserable people in one place in your life unless you've recently been to a funeral. God's sake. Right. Who is Rod Brown? Why is he one of the millions of viewers watching this show? That's who Rod is. Nice man. Good. Let's have... hello, Ian. Ian Thrussell's with us this morning. Now, Ian used to be top London DJ. He worked at a place in London called GAY for years and years and years. He's not there anymore. And he's gone from DJing to get this... driving HGV trucks. Ian, I've got to come for a little ride. I've never been in one of those. Not when it's moving, anyway. Please, can I come in your HGV truck? That would be fantastic. A HGV truck. All right. Let's do... where are we going now? you want to know how Ronnie is. Ronnie is, he had a plasma injection last night. He had a plasma injection yesterday afternoon, actually. And I saw him yesterday afternoon, and he wasn't too bad. Now, where did we go yesterday? Did we go anywhere yesterday? No, I just went up to his house and Saturday. It wasn't too bad. Now, this morning, we were supposed to go out and get our hair cut. We are now looking for a new barber's. Because I do feel, if you heard the story last week where I went and had my hair cut, it's usually £10 and it comes to the end. And I always give 15. I give them £5 tip. I'm very good at tipping. Very, very good at tipping. And he said, oh, it's £13 now. Oh, is it? He said, yeah, there's a sign on the front there. It's now £13 Friday to Sunday. Or it's £10. It's still the normal price Monday to Thursday. Now, I don't mind if you're going to increase the price. Okay? I think a sudden £3 increase is a bit much. But had you told me before you started, oh, just to let you know, before you start, that's okay. But you didn't. He told me after the job was done. So I'm not happy. Not happy about that at all. So we're now looking for another hairdresser. But do you know, it's really difficult, certainly outside of London, to find a proper Turkish hairdresser's what does, burning hairs in the ears and the hot towel and you know, the massaging and all that. Oh, there's plenty of hairdressers, but I don't want to go to some young blonde bimbo, you know, who's going to come with her hair clippers. £10, please. No, dear. No. I mean, they do a good job. But I do feel a little bit ripped off there. They did say, well, you don't have to pay it this time. No, if it's 13 now, there you go. And I smile on my face. I didn't know anything was wrong. I didn't say anything. But I've thought about it and I thought, no, I'm not happy with that. Not happy that that happened. So I'm looking for a new hairdresser at the moment, Wendy. And we were going to go out today and look for one. I think it's already checked on the internet. But they don't always... The only thing is hairdressers... websites are not always, well, number one, there's not always one there. Sometimes they're not very good. You're not quite sure what they do and all that. So we're looking for one of those at the moment. But he's texted me, actually, while the show was on. A little text flashed up on my little screen in front of me, informing me that he's in great pain today. So I'm going to go over there a little bit later on. I'll probably walk up to the swimming pool. Sometimes I cycle up to the swimming pool because that saves like 20 minutes. And then I'll go over to his house. So that's how he is at the moment. All right. Well, thank you very much for asking, Wendy. I shall let him know. Good. Tim says, a Beckham carpool update. This comment from Barry, who took to justjarred.com to post. Victoria Beckham singing. The other Spice Girls certainly took a ticket to see that. Parking or a train? Excellent, excellent. Good morning to Kevin Webster, just joining us this morning. Ray Reynolds says, Sainsbury's is full of pensioners of pond life. You never get in and out quickly. There's always a problem at the checkout. Oh, I can't stand it in there. I can't stand it. It's not just pensioners. There's certainly a lot of pond life in there. Dreadful people in there, Sainsbury's. Awful. Not going anymore, if I can help it. Let's do some news, boys and girls. Don't stand too close to me. Don't stand too close to me. Now, are you one of those people that likes a bit of space around you? Or perhaps, you know, you like to be close to people, pushing up against them in the tube station, you naughty people. Is that what you do? You wait till someone good-looking, young and pert gets on that tube train and then you go and stand next to them and push up against them. You mustn't do that, dear. You mustn't. You're a pervert. You naughty pervert. Mind the gap, because the closest a Briton can stand next to a stranger, where is it now? Without feeling uncomfortable, is only 3 feet, dear. 3 feet. You mustn't stand closer to anyone than that. Coming any nearer makes us feel awkward, even if we don't show it. Researchers found that Ardentines were the... Is it Ardentines or Ardentinians? Or is it both? Argentinians, or don't mention the Falklands, dear. Don't mention the Falklands, whatever you do, dear. Mind the gap. Researchers found that Argentinians were the most relaxed with strangers and set a limit of... Now, why are they doing this? So they've done half of it in blooming feet and the other bit in foreign metric. What's all that about? Oh, I'm going to have to work that. I haven't got a tape ruler here, have I? Oh, anyway, researchers found that Argentinians were the most relaxed with strangers and set a limit of 76.5 centimetres before they felt uneasy. Romanians like to keep the biggest gap at 1.39 metres. What's that, 1.39 metres? Is that about 3 foot? I don't know what that is. We were more comfortable at closer distances than those in China, Portugal or Brazil. The study said cultural differences could be behind the differences, but other factors were at play. So in Romania, they like you to be quite far away. 1.39 metres. I mean, how would you chat someone up like that? Let's just try that. Hello, can I buy you a drink, please? Can I buy you a drink, please? Oh, can I buy... Oh, sorry, too close. Can I buy you a drink? Would you like a drink? I mean, you'd give up, wouldn't you? Blimey. You'd give up after a while. There wouldn't be anyone here. Especially if there's loads of people in the middle and some annoying DJ banging out loud music on S Club 7, dear. But, where are we on this one? UK, 90, okay, so UK 99.4 centimetres. So that's nearly a metre. So what's that? That's for like here to here, isn't it? Well, that's not too bad. You know, I mean, you wouldn't quite get your tongue in their mouth from that distance, would you? But you could spit, perhaps. Well, these people clearly haven't been on buses and tube trains, have they? 1 metre, do me a favour. The story goes on. In general, those in warmer countries were more likely to want to stand closer, but older generations and women prefer to be further apart. In warmer countries, they want to stand closer. You'd think that'd be the other way round, wouldn't you? They get too hot. A lot of people get very hot when they see me walking through town. You know, with my muscle top vest and that sort of thing on. Yes. The research led by academics at the University of what? Wrocław in Poland involved almost asking 9,000 participants from 42 countries. Americans and Germans are more at ease at closer distances than the British. That's it. We all need to move to America, boys and girls. If you want to get close to someone, you need to move to America. That's the only way to do it. Mind you, some of the little films that I watch sometimes at night when I come in, there's a lot of Americans on there. They want to go closer and deeper, closer and deeper. That's what they say on those films. Anne says, like MySpace, unless I'm talking to you or Barry Manilow. Looks like we made it. But, oh, do you know, when I sing a Barry song like that, you know when I sing a Barry song to you like that, like usually the first line or two, I can actually hear the orchestra in my head. Oh, it's wonderful, isn't it? When's he coming here? I think he just announced. Isn't he on QVC soon? Barry Manilow's on QVC. QVC. I have to admit, I've stopped following him on Twitter because, honestly, the endless Twitters and retweets from people started to get my nerves. Every few minutes, my phone was going off. Beep, 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 all the time. Oh, I set up my new chime, by the way. You know my new gadget that I got yesterday you saw? That's all set up and working wonderfully, I'm pleased to say. Tim says it's happy 78th birthday to the 45 RPM single. Oh, got one here. One moment, please. Where is a 40? Oh, there's one. Oh, God. Anyway. Now, is there anyone young watching today? Nope, didn't think so. This is a 45 RPM single. This is a wonderful piece of technology. Look at this. This is actually Barry Manilow, ready to take a chance again. And Sweet Life. I don't know the one, Sweet Life. Sadly, I've got nothing to play it on anymore. I MP3'd my collection some years ago. That is a wonderful... Isn't it lovely holding that piece of technology? That is a 45 RPM single. Introduced by RCA Victor this day in 1949, thanks to Richard Allenson, legendary radio broadcaster for that retreat. Yes, he is indeed. Yes, he is. Vector says, have you got any fit cameramen working each of those cameras? No, sadly not. I don't think there are cameramen anymore, are there? I think it's a producer or what are they called? A vision controller sitting there with a little joystick. It's all automatic now. I don't need that anymore. I wanted to be a TV cameraman, Vector. That was one of the jobs I wanted to do as a boy. Correct. Tim also says it's Argentinians or Arges. Oh, dear, dear, dear. Right. Some more news stories for you boys and girls. More news, more news. Now, this is fairly sensible from Jan Moyer. Now, I'm not always keen on some of the stuff that she writes in the Daily Mail, but this morning, something has to be done about revenge porn. Now, revenge porn is when you disgusting people, probably you, not me, probably you, make little films of them and their other halves doing things, and then when they split up, they post them up online. What do you mean, where? Oh, honestly, you're so filthy and you want to see them now, don't you? Okay, if you go to No. That's what they do. They film themselves doing stuff. Then they split up. And, of course, one or the other has got the film. And then they post it online. Revenge porn. Usually for being dumped. Has that happened to you recently? Have you been dumped? Jan writes, something has to be done about it. But what? Keeping your pants on would be a good start, but that's just too dull and sensible for today's generation of thrill-seeking exhibitionists. You know, I go so far along with this. There's one reason why the practice of men, it's almost always men tormenting former lovers by posting private videos and photographs of them online is on the increase. But how can it be policed? There is a revenge porn offence, which was put in 2015. It's helped with more than 200 offenders being prosecuted in the first year. But her answer and my answer to this is don't make the films. Why have you got to film yourself doing stuff like that all the time anyway? Do you really think that film's going to disappear when you get dumped? No, they'll hold on to it for years. Years. There's none of me, so don't start looking around. So there's the answer to that one. If you don't want to be done for revenge porn, and doesn't matter how much you fancy someone or love them, it might go wrong. Perhaps that's the wrong attitude to take. That's perhaps why I'm on my own. You know, because I'm always thinking, oh, well, if it goes wrong, then it goes wrong. You know, maybe I shouldn't think like that. But don't make the films. It's not hard, is it? Don't be stupid enough to make the films in the first place and it can't happen. All right? Now, there's a new Lego item. Oh, let's see if anyone's commented on that. I just don't fancy having the phones open today. Is that all right with you? You didn't want to call in anyway, did you? Oh, you wanted me to tell you, didn't you? That thing. You wanted me to tell you. I got to tell you. When we have phone calls, it's all well and good. But there's one particular person who calls in sometimes. And the callers just, and the viewers just drop off very quickly. Oh, I cannot reveal to you that person's name or even whether it's a woman, man, young or old. There's a particular caller that calls in. And the viewers just drop off like dead flies. They really do. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. Stephen says you should do some stand-up comedy. I don't think so, Stephen. No. Not interested. You know, funnily enough, our good friend Simon Keane said that a few times, that I should be doing something like that. But no, I've no interest in doing that whatsoever, really. I like to just sit here and have a little bit of a chin wag with you. You know that. A little bit of a chin wag. Yes, so another story here. If you are a Disney fan, you will want... Don't show your children this particular programme because you will be begged for one of these. Are you ready for this? There is a new Disney castle that you can make yourself out of Lego. Have you seen it? Unfortunately, I can't show you a picture of it. If you type in Lego Disney castle, then you will find it. Bring the magical world of Disney to your home with this wonderful Lego Disney castle. This highly detailed Lego model with over 4,000 pieces offers a rewarding build and play experience and comes with an array of exciting Disney-themed features and functions. The intricately detailed facade and towers replicate the iconic Walt Disney World Resort Cinderella Castle, and each accessible castle room and each accessible castle room includes special features inspired by some of Disney's greatest animated feature films, providing endless play possibilities with the included minifigure Minnie Mouse, Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck, Daisy Duck and Tinkerbell, or other characters from your collection. So that's it, and it's quite good. It measures 29 inches high and 18 inches wide and 12 inches deep. 4,000 pieces. And lots more. So that does sound like a nice present, doesn't it? For a child, perhaps? How much? Any idea? How much do you think the new Lego Disneyland castle is? 80 quid? Bit dear, isn't it? 80 quid. 80 quid? No, not 80 quid. 50 quid? No, gone the wrong way. What, more than 80? Yes, more than 80. 90 quid? No, not £90. No. Try £299.99. I kid you not. The new Lego Disney castle is a penny under £300. I won't lie, it looks lovely. It looks really nice. But I tell you what, it does not look £300. I'd give you for that. And remember, my head and money is kind of stuck still at the 80s, really. I'd happily give you, at a push, 50 quid for that. They want £299.99 for the Lego Disney castle. Type it into your little browser, boys and girls. Lego Disney castle, and you can have a look at that. Who's going to get one of those for their children at Christmas? Shocking. Tim says £300. Elaine says 200. No, £299, Elaine. God's sake. Tim says apparently the Batcave in the current Lego Batman movie, if actually constructed to scale, would be half a mile long. Fectus, we can't afford to lose any viewers. You know that, darling. We're desperate as it is. Desperate as it is. Elaine's a big fit Disney fan. Elaine, would you pay £300 for a Lego Disney castle? It's shockingly expensive. Shockingly expensive. I don't know how they're getting away with that. All right. We carry on with today's little news stories, boys and girls. Here's one. Jones claims reptile aliens spread fake Russia-Trump story to spark global war. We're all a bit worried about war at the moment, aren't we? Because we've got a few mad people running things. You know, King Jing Jong Jing Jong. We've got Donald Trump. And the nice man in Russia, who actually I don't think is all bad. I don't think that man in Russia is bad at all. I think it's all fake news. It's the fake media. The fake media, boys and girls, that are trying to make us hate the Russian people for some reason. I don't know why. I think it's all right, that Russian bloke. The story goes by Mary Washington. As the net begins to tighten on President Donald Trump, he continues to try to deflect attention away from the charges that his campaign colluded with Russia to steal the 2016 presidential election. In an act of desperation, he recently went on a tweet storm accusing former President Bill Clinton, who I quite like, I have not had relationships with that woman. Did he ever get that stain out? In an act of desperation, he recently went on a tweet storm according former President Bill Clinton and former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. Hello, I'm Hillary Clinton. I am a robot. Hello, 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 Hillary Clinton here. Hillary Clinton, Hillary Clinton, Hillary Clinton, Hillary Clinton. I'll tell you what was cruel. You know that time she... Oh, when she wasn't well. That was horrible, that was. Remember when she was getting into the car? Do you remember that? One minute. She was getting into the car, weren't she? Poor Hillary. And all the newspapers took photos. That was horrible. She had pneumonia, didn't she? Isn't it funny, though? The Americans seem to talk about pneumonia as if it's just like a bad cold. Don't know. Have you noticed that? Whereas when you get it here, well, you've got about an hour to live. I wonder why that is. Anyway, back to the story. Many of Trump's supporters continue to downplay the Russia story. According to Raw Story, some Trump supporters said they were okay with Russia influencing the election because of liberal media. It's all fake news. Conspiracy theorist Alex Jones had an even more outrageous explanation. He blamed the allegations on shape-shifting reptilian aliens who had infiltrated the government. That bloke who used to present Grandstand, he's always on about them, isn't he? What's his name? Ian Dyke. Greg Dyke? No. Ian. Oh, gosh. What's his name, someone? Someone tell me. Used to present Grandstand. Can't remember his name now. Always gone about going on about reptiles taking over the earth. Well, it's here. The reptilians are deeply embedded in the government, said Jones on his show InfoWars. They leaked the fake Russia story to spark a war between them and the United States. Their goal is to take over the world, and that would be much easier if we destroyed ourselves. So that's it. We've got to destroy ourselves. Jones recently apologised for spreading fake stories about Pizzagate, a rumour about a Washington, D.C. pizzeria, which was supposed to be holding sex slaves. For Hillary Clinton, Edgar Madison Welsh, a Jones listener, was arrested after he stormed a pizzeria with a gun in an attempt to free the slaves. Dreadful, dear. Dreadful. Anyone remember what that bloke's name was? Who used to host Grandstand? David Icke. Thank you, Aaron. David Icke. That's the one, Stephen. David Icke. Yes. Napen Vaporboy Edwards. Good morning. Says, you forgot Theresa Thatcher. What about her? Do you think we need a Lego model of Theresa Thatcher? We like Miss May. We like Mother May. I'm a great fan of Mrs. May. I'm trying to arrange a cup of tea with her. Perhaps for her to come in, she can come into the studio. She'll bring her detective with her, you know, great big burly man with a gun. Just a little man with a gun or something like that. Trying to get her into the studio at this moment. Feelers are out. We won't be doing politics. We're going to find out what she did as a little girl, what her parents did, and what she likes to do in her spare time. And I will personally go out and purchase a pair of shoes for Theresa May as a gift for coming into the studios of United Kingdom Talk and its associated networks and affiliates. Thank you. Yes. Good morning, Aaron. How are you, Aaron? Who says, yes, the superhero Lego exhibition at Southbank is £16 a ticket. Well, it'd be better than buying that castle for 300 quid, wouldn't it? Mind you can afford it, don't you? You carry on, Nathan. You say what you want on here, mate. Just remember, it's a light-hearted show. We're not doing serious here. So if you've got a political agenda, then bye. Light-hearted, that's it. Jimmy Butler's with us this morning. Why aren't you at work this morning, Jimmy? That's my nephew, Jimmy Butler, there. Nephew Jimmy Butler is in the house this morning. Have you just woken up? What, 25 past 11? Well, it's a bit late, isn't it? I'll have to go soon. One more story for you today, boys and girls. Losing his head. This is in this morning's Super Soraway Sun. A suspected murderer was arrested after he was seen carrying his ex-wife's head down the street and then tried to set fire to it in a skip, said the Israeli police. This bloke allegedly decapitated. There's certain countries I won't go to, you know. They cut your heads off. You've seen it on the telly, dear. They cut heads off. What are they going to do with my... They won't want my head. It'll just keep talking at them. This bloke allegedly decapitated his ex-wife Adele's head. Oh, not the Adele. That'd be a big head, wouldn't it? Would it keep singing? I wish Adele would bring it. I love Adele. I think she's fab. She's ordinary and she's very talented. But the songs are so dreary, Adele. Can we have something happy? Perhaps you could redo a Wham song, you know, Freedom or something like that. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah, hey, hey, ba, 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 ba. Something like that, Adele. Maybe we could do a duet together, you, Adele and me. Adele, if you're watching this show today, perhaps you'd like to come along to our central station karaoke tonight and do a little duet with me. What about Break My Stride, Matthew Wilder? I like that one. Ain't nothing gonna break my stride. Nobody gonna slow me down. Oh no, I got to keep on moving. That one. A witness in Tiberias in northeast Israel on the western shore of the Sea of Galilee, where I have been to the Sea of Galilee. Galilee. Didn't have time to do fishing though. Jesus caught all those. There are no fish left there. Jesus caught them all. Sea of Galilee, said, he approached me as if nothing had happened. Is this the woman who's cut her head off? Oh, no, this is someone else. He approached me as if nothing had happened. He asked me to call the fire brigade as his apartment was on fire. I handed him my phone, but he said I should make the call. He was holding the head under his arm like a helmet wrapped in a towel. Oh, my word. At first, I didn't realise what it was. I thought it was a mannequin's head. It was only then I realised it was covered in blood. I asked him about the blood and I said I would call the police and he started backing away from me. He put the head behind a skip and tried to light it on fire. But he was shaking. He was shaking. You shouldn't say that. Maybe he had Parkinson's disease. You don't know? I think you're being cruel to people that shake. He might be offended. He was shaking and couldn't light the match. He didn't say a thing. Even when the cops came, he said nothing. He just held out his hands and let them cuff him. Cuff me, please, someone cuff me. The bloke, who was recently divorced by the victim, moves to Israel from Moldova in 1991. The couple have no children. Dear, dear me. We don't want to go to Israel, do you? You might have your heads cut off there. Be very, very careful, boys and girls. There we are. They're today's news stories for you, boys and girls. We've had a little bit of a chat, haven't we, Annette? Now, one of the items today, as always, was fake news. Could you tell which one it was this morning? Fake, it's all fake news. Fake news, boys and girls. Oh. Incorrect soundbite. I'm so disappointed. That was all going so smoothly until then, except for the non-sound. When you... No, the sound isn't working. It is working. It's me doing it, you see? Could you tell which one was the fake news item? Send your messages in, boys and girls. Which one do you think this morning was the fake news item? Let me know what you thought. Adam says, was it the one with the head cut off? Morning to Mark. Have you just managed to get up, Mark? Come on. Very, very late. Nathan says it wouldn't have been a clean cut. Well, you don't know, darling. Was the blade sharp or not? Nathan says, you never know what she might say. Hello from the other side once her head is cut off. What, Adele? Hello, hello. Oh, it's so depressing, that song. Good morning to John Springate, international cabaret artist, singer, musician and everything, John. Good morning, John. How are you? You don't want to have a go at remaking one of those theme tunes for me, do you, John? Shall I send it to you? Or is that a bit naughty? Or is that, would that be offensive to the person who wrote it in the first place? Maybe it would be, yes. But you haven't got him anymore, has he? my nephew says, all cars went out Wednesday. Is currently in bed, not well. Oh, no. My nephew's not well. It's his birthday tomorrow. My nephew, Jimmy Butler, is 20 years old tomorrow. Yes. He's got his own business. JB Cars Auto Repairs and Spaceship Repairs he does. He now repairs, as well as cars, he's repairing spaceships as well. Because, as you know, I don't have a car. I don't have a car. I have a Class A Starship that flies through the night and through the day to all parts of the universe. I don't have a car, dear. No. It's fitted with warp drive, phasers, photon torpedoes, everything, dear. It's got a cloaking device, so when I can see the Borg cubes, cleverly disguised as speed cameras. No, not safety cameras. Speed cameras. They're speed cameras. No, they're safety cameras. They're not. No, they're not. Mr. Policeman, they're not safety cameras. They're speed cameras to get as much money out. You can't say anything to change my mind. I find that offensive that you call our safety cameras speed cameras. They're speed cameras. Go away. Go away. Speed cameras are, in fact, Borg cubes from Star Trek disguised as cameras. That's what they are. Hello, John. MIDI versions. I'm not sure. I'm not quite sure what MIDI versions are. Is that the? Yeah, I'm not quite sure what that is. I'll send you one. See how you can get on with it, John. Perhaps I could send you a little something in return, like a United Kingdom Talk television mug. Would you like one of those? Might be. There might. I would have to look very closely to see if there's one in here somewhere. I don't know if there could be. I don't know if you could be. Adam says, if it was the head, it must have been a Wilkinson sword because it's the best a man can get. It is indeed. It's April Fool's tomorrow, Mark. Mark says it's April Fool's Day tomorrow, Mark. Yes. Remember that. Will there be an April Fool from me? I haven't thought of one, actually. Do you know what I did last year? I told everyone I had a job at the BBC and that I wasn't going to do the show anymore. I had all these emails coming in. Oh, congratulations. Right. So what was this morning's fake news story? Oh, that's twice I've done that now. God's sake. Hang on a minute.
We are fighting the fake news. It's fake, phony, fake. A few days ago, I called the fake news the enemy of the people, and they are. They are the enemy of the people. They're very dishonest people that I called the fake news the enemy of the people, the fake news. And now I'm saying, oh, no, this is no good. But you are fake news. But I am only against the fake news media or press. Fake.
Fake. All fake. It's all fake news. And this morning's fake news story was, a lot of you thought it was the head. The head's what the story has come straight out of the sun this morning. The fake news was the one with Jones claiming reptilian aliens spread fake Russia-Trump story to start global war. Now, to make it easier, for you this morning, I actually said a few times while I was reading that story that it was fake news. And you never got it. You never got it. It's all fake news. Thank you, John. It's all fake news. So the fake news story this morning was the one about the reptilians. Okay, boys and girls. Alrighty, we're going to disappear. Let me just check. What have I haven't done something this morning. What haven't I done? Birthdays. I haven't done today's birthdays, have I? Sorry, I haven't done today's birthdays. Very important. Birthday people get very upset if I don't do their birthdays. So, this morning, it's my cousin's birthday. Cousin Helen Ryan. Oh, cousin Helen. Happy birthday, Helen. She'll have, I don't know what she's doing for her birthday this morning, so I must give her a personal telephone call this morning. You can have a personal telephone call if you want. They are slightly extra at £10 plus your normal network rates. All right? You must get your call in by 12 o'clock. After 12 o'clock, I'm afraid your call won't be counted and you may still be charged £1.50 for the call. Thank you very much. So happy birthday to Helen Ryan, my cousin. Happy birthday to the very gorgeous, very, very sexy, someone I've known for years and years, Jessica James. And whatever she does, she never gives up. She never gives up what she's doing. So happy birthday to the lovely Jessica James this morning, who's setting up, or I can't remember if you have set up, but she's got this radio station, Transistor Radio. Jessica James is a trans person, okay? She's gone from boy to woman, and she's setting up this, got this radio station. She has got this radio. So what am I talking about? She's got this radio set up called Transistor Radio for all transgender people. So that's fantastic. What a fantastic. I think that's the first one in the world as well. You know, so happy birthday to you, Jessica. Okay, darling. Happy birthday to Jessarinho. Well, Cotso Carol, I'm not going to be able to say your name, but happy birthday to you. A lovely smiley face on your Facebook this morning. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to the lovely Carla Zwack Halen, 57 today. One of our beautiful, beautiful Manolo ladies. Aren't you, Carla? Who I met up with at, where was it? I think two places. O2. And Florida as well, possibly. I think it was Florida as well. Happy birthday to you, darling. All right. Happy birthday to Brighton Charles, a very young 27. Raymond Hind is 46 today. Dominic Welsh, hello, Dominic, 24 today. Adam Boyle is 28 today. And Daniel Jacob Farrell McSweeney. What a long name. Also, 28 seems to be a popular number today, doesn't it? Happy birthday to you all. Let's sing the song, boys and girls. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. All right. Have a lovely birthday. I see there's been a couple of you there on Periscope this morning. Thanks very much for joining us on Periscope as well. You are actually better to watch the show on Facebook Live. If you want to either friend or follow me on there, you don't have to be friends. If you click the follow button, then you'll get the notifications there. My Facebook is facebook.com/ChrisReardonUK, right? facebook.com/ChrisReardonUK if you need me there. Anne says, haven't put your trousers on. Ooh, me? No, I don't put my trousers on. I've got tracksuit bottoms on here. You only see the bit I need you to see. I only bother dressing that bit up. And it's only my face. I never shower anymore. I just wash my face so it looks clean. I actually stink this morning. I can, mind you, not as bad as that cat poo. The cat left me as I came in from work last night. Neatly done on one of my puppy pads. Oh, can I just tell you about the puppy pads before I finish today? Remember those puppy pads I showed you? They got little sticky bits on each corner to hold them to the floor. Unfortunately, the sticky bit remained on the floor when I removed the puppy pad. So my sister says to me, my lovely sister, she says, I can get that off with now varnish remover. I think I might try white spirit as well. That's quite good for getting sticky off the floor. So puppy pads, very good. They soak up the wee and the poo smell. But unfortunately, when you pick them off, the puppy pad comes, the sticky bits remain on the floor, which is a little bit of a bad design there. I suppose, mind you, you know, what do? Do you have them less sticky? Then they might not stick to the floor anyway, mightn't they? So I've got to get those up. John Springate offered money. What have you been offered money for, John? What have you been offered money for? I'm going to go now. Tonight, it's Friday night. I'll be hosting karaoke this evening, boys and girls. That's at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. Karaoke every single Friday from 8:30 until midnight at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross. So I hope some of you can join me there. Thank you very much for joining us on the show today. It's time to disappear into the abyss, boys and girls. I'm going to go swimming out and then go up and see my mate and his bad arm. Have a lovely Friday, and I'll see you again very soon. Bye-bye now.